IntelliJ IDEA has support for creating, reviewing, and merging GitHub pull requests. These features are available if the IntelliJ IDEA project has a remote that points to GitHub or GitHub Enterprise. There are a number of ways to open the pull requests tool window. One is to go to the VCS menu, go to Git, and select View Pull Requests. If we haven't already logged into GitHub via IntelliJ IDEA, the tool window will provide a link to log in. There are different options to log in. We can pick the one that suits us best. Now I've logged in using a token, the pull request window will by default show all the open pull requests for the GitHub repository. We can change the search criteria to look for specific pull requests, and IntelliJ IDEA will offer code completion where possible. This search lets us easily find pull requests that meet our specific criteria. We can see the details of a specific pull request by double-clicking on it. We'll look at individual pull requests in more detail later. We can go back to the list of search results by pressing the Back to List link in the top right of the Pull Requests tool window. Let's look for open pull requests, since these are the ones that need attention. Let's double-click or press Enter on one of these pull requests. If the pull request has reviewers assigned, we can see them here. If it's assigned to anyone, we'll see that too. The files that make up the pull request are shown in the bottom left window, and the conversation, which includes a timeline for commits and other status changes as well as comments, is shown in the main editor area. If there are inline comments on the code, we can see them here. But we can also click on the files to see not only the changes, but also the comments on those files. Let's close this so we can see the pull request conversation again. The conversation shows everything you'd expect to see on the GitHub pull request conversation page. It also shows the result of any checks that were run, and we can open this in a browser if we want to see more details. IntelliJ IDEA also shows if there are any conflicts, so we know if this pull request is safe to merge or not. We can open any of the files that make up the pull request, and IntelliJ IDEA will show them in the diff viewer, so we can see the changes that make up the pull request. We can then navigate through the changes the same way we would usually look at changes in a commit in IntelliJ IDEA. Inline comments will be displayed in the diff view too. There are a number of ways to open the pull request window. One of them is to use the Recent Files dialog, which lets us also open up any of the tool windows. This is also searchable, so we can type pull to find what we're looking for. We've seen the summary info, the conversation, and the files for a pull request. Finally, we can see the commits that make up the pull request by opening up the Commits tab at the top. We can look at the files that make up each of the commits here, and see the differences for each file if we want to. That's an overview of how we can view a pull request. Let's look at the process of creating and reviewing a pull request. IntelliJ IDEA has let us create pull requests for a while now. In this example, we've made some changes on a branch called Feature 123. We can go to VCS, Git, and select Create Pull Request. This project has two remotes, so we're offered both as an option for our pull request. The Create Pull Request dialog does give us the option to change the fork and the branch if we want to. Let's give the pull request a description to help the reviewers. When it's created, we can open it in the browser to see the details on GitHub. Now let's look at this pull request inside IntelliJ IDEA. We can open the pull requests window from the Tool Windows menu in the bottom left. Once again, we see all the open pull requests. This repository only has one, which is the pull request we just created. Let's take a look at it. Once again, we can see the conversation, the commit activity, the commits themselves, the files in the commits, and the changes to those files. We can see that there was one check on the pull request and that this has passed. We can add comments to the GitHub conversation. These are comments that apply to the top level, not to specific pieces of code. We can edit and delete these comments inside IntelliJ IDEA. These comments are synchronized with GitHub, and we can see them on the pull request conversation page there. If we go back to see the information about this pull request, we can add reviewers based on the repository's collaborators. We could also assign the pull request if this is part of our workflow. We can add labels, which can help us triage or sort the pull requests. All of this is synced automatically with GitHub. Whether we're an author or a reviewer, we might want to add comments on particular parts of the code. We can do this from inside IntelliJ IDEA, for example, by clicking on the plus in the gutter of the diff viewer. For this example, let's choose to add a single comment to the current pull request. We can edit or delete these comments, reply to it, and we can resolve a comment that no longer needs to be considered. For example, if the code has changed according to the suggestions. Let's go back to the pull requests window. This time, let's open it from View, Tool Windows, Pull Requests. Now we have another pull request to look at, and we're going to use this to explore some other features. Let's assume that I've opened this pull request because the changes are interesting to me and I want to make some comments to the author. I can start a review of this pull request by writing an inline comment. We can see that the comment shows as pending, and if we look back at the pull requests window, the Submit Review button is now blue and shows the number of comments in brackets. If we write more comments, we can see this number updating. Now I can submit a review with a top-level comment on the pull request. If we go back to the conversation on GitHub, we can see the review and the comments on the code. One feature that's really helpful when we're reviewing a pull request is that we can check out the code that is in this pull request. In this project, I'm currently on branch feature 456. Let's check out the code for feature 123 and create a new branch for it. Now I can really easily navigate all the code for the repository that relates to this pull request. This lets me not only look at the code, but also run tests and potentially make changes too. Finally, let's look at how to finish off the pull request. We could close it if we're not going to take the changes that went into the pull request. Or if all the checks have passed, all the questions have been answered, and the code looks good to go, we can merge this pull request. We can add our own commit message for the merge if we want to. The pull request will be merged, and if we do a fetch, we can see the updated branches for this repository. We can see via our browser that the pull request has been closed. That's a summary of the key features for GitHub pull requests in IntelliJ IDEA. Thanks for watching.